The 150th game being completed on this channel is Bad Dudes vs Dragon Ninja. I downloaded this on Switch as part of that double pack with two crude dudes. I'm playing the arcade original, although thanks to memes, I'm fairly certain the NES port is more famous. Basically, there's been a rise in ninja-related crimes, culminating in the kidnapping of Ronald Reagan by ninjas. Then our player characters, Blade and Stryker, are pressured into saving him through this guy putting their masculinity into question. Do it yourself if you're such a bad dude, asshole. I, as Blade, can walk, punch, kick and jump between the two heights available on screen. There's also attacks for holding the stick in different directions too. There's some special attacks, but most enemies die in one hit, so I never really bothered. I get ninjas that try fighting me hand to hand, ninjas that throw shurikens along the ground, ninjas wielding knives. There's a big lorry passes by in the background, I get killed by a dog. One woman runs up to me and I jump kick her out to take a knife. Then comes a ninja with a sword who keeps trying to Zelda 2 downstab me. A little bit further and the first boss is Karnov from Data East's Karnov. I've never played a Karnov game, so this is all I know him for. He mainly does somersaults around the screen and breathes fire at me. I keep making him waste time jumping between the layers so I can keep stabbing him. He does get a kill on me, but I punch him out afterwards. Stage 1 complete. The next stage takes place on top of the lorry as the game's best track plays. The first two enemies drop a cola that I can pick up to recover a bit of health. Some jump in from off screen, but others pass by standing on the roofs of cars and jump to me. The screen auto-scrolls, but very slowly. Eventually I can jump over to the next trailer. But the thing is, there are no new enemies, so there is just nothing left to talk about until the screen scrolls all the way and I reach the front. At which point the lorry stops and I can climb down to face the boss, Short Shredder. I don't know the official name. He's got various claw attacks and I don't really know a good way to avoid them since I'm kind of slow, so I just go brute force and kick him to death. Stage 3 puts me in a sewer. So here I am, watching this footage back to write a script, and there's honestly barely anything going on. The first interesting thing is that sometimes you can see the chutes for ninjas hiding in the shitty sewer water are breathing through before they jump up. There's some gaps in the floor that you can fall through and die too, I suppose. I finally get something new when a demoted pallet swap stage 2 boss shows up. He's got much smaller claws as well. Then I meet the boss, a ninja in green who creates many doubles of himself. They all die in one hit, but I have to kill them all first before I can even damage the main one. Alone, he just does a few punches and kicks and after taking some damage, creates more doubles, so I just keep repeating the cycle until he's down. Stage 4 puts me in a forest next. The new thing with this stage is that there is a bit of vertical scrolling. After moving along the level for a bit, the screen scrolls up to get rid of the top layer and create a new bottom layer. The first new enemy is a naked man on fire who runs by and doesn't harm me. That's about it though, the screen scrolls up and down a couple more times as I move forward but there's nothing else new until I reach the boss. Some Fist of the North style looking arsehole with a massive health bar. He has the usual punches and kicks, but his unique attack is a dropkick. This is an incredibly boring fight. Slowly approach and hope he doesn't kill me first before I can plink a tiny bit of his health bar away. This took 2 minutes, the same length of time the entire rest of the stage took. Stage 5 is another auto-scroller, but across a train and this time going left. And also the screen moves much faster, thankfully. Okay, so literally nothing happens worth bringing up until the end. It's all the same enemies and I jump more gaps than I did in stage 2. Near the end I face a zombie-ish Karnov as a mini-boss. And then when I reach the front of the train, it's a guy with a Kusarigama and a trident on the other end. He has much more range than me so I just keep jump kicking, hoping to outspeed him. Up close he can also hit me with the sickle end. That's about it. It's another long and boring one but nowhere near as long as stage 4's boss. Stage 6 puts me in a cave. I sometimes get stalactites falling from the ceiling, and I think this is the first time in the game a ninja throws a smoke bomb at me. I learn I can also kick a falling stalactite and win. The screen scrolls down after a bit and for the first time I manage to steal enemy nunchuck. They're very helpful with the extra range. Moving down some more, Zombie Karnov just seems to be a regular enemy now. And then it's just a load of enemy spam until the boss. I get lucky and punch him while he's still in the middle of entering the screen. He has a staff and mainly spins around the screen or does leaping kicks off of it. At one point I stun lock him with a jump kick and then kick away about a third of his health at once before he breaks out. The rest of it takes longer though as he just keeps spinning through most of it. Stage 7 is the final level inside the enemy headquarters. About 2 minutes of heading downwards fighting the same enemies until I reach the boss rush. First Zombie Karnov one last time. Then Zombie Stage 4 boss comes down in a lift. I take him out and ride the lift up to rematch the Stage 2 boss. But this one doesn't have a zombie-ish skin tone. After him I move left to face a stage 3 ninja dude and then the guy from stage 5 and finally the stage 6 boss. After that I reach the final boss, some guy in an Oni mask backed up by a load of dogs. He hangs out in a helicopter throwing firebombs down at me. When the helicopter lowers I have the chance to jump up and hit him, but even up there his punches are very strong. What follows is a couple minutes of me dying while mashing kick against his face until he's finally down. The helicopter lands and ray gun emerges. You can't hit him, by the way. And for all my effort, he repays me with a burger. That's it. You've probably worked it out by my tone during this video, but I didn't care for this game. It's not an awful game or anything, but it's just so bland. They throw out pretty much all the enemies right away, of which there aren't many, then give very little variation after that. Most of the bosses are just tedious to get through, and the levels themselves aren't even fun to look at. All he has going for it is that one music track. Were it not for the meme, there would be nothing worth remembering this game for. Hell, I myself forgot I even recorded this playthrough for a few months right after finishing it.